Hello students, welcome back to our geography session. Today we shall start with a new topic, the sun, the moon and the earth. Children, you all know that the sun, the moon and the earth are the most important aspects of our life. Sun is the heart of our solar system. The moon is the natural satellite of the earth. And earth, it is the most important. Earth is a planet on which we live. Let us start with the first subtopic, the moon's motion. Like the earth, the moon also has axial and orbital motions. First, let us clear the concept of axial and orbital motions. Students, in the previous lesson, we had studied that the earth takes 24 hours to rotate around its own axis and 365 days and 6 hours to complete one revolution. Similarly, the moon also has the axial and orbital motions. Axial motion. The motion of the moon, that is the movement of the moon around its own axis, is called its axial motion. Orbital. The moon, while moving around its axis, also revolves around the earth, which is known as its orbital motion. Rotation and revolution of the moon. Rotation. Like the earth, the moon also rotates around itself. Revolution. The moon revolves around the earth, and it is the earth that revolves around the sun. So, the moon does not revolve directly, but it revolves indirectly around the sun. Now let us see the time taken by the moon. The time taken by the moon to complete one rotation and revolution is the same. That means it takes about 1 month to complete the rotation and revolution process. Therefore, we can see only one side of the moon. Now let's test your brain power. Think about it. Like sunlight and moonlight, is there anything called the earth light? If yes, where do you think it is found? Answer. Yes. Like sunlight and moonlight, we also have the earth light. When the sunlight reaches the earth, the light is reflected on the darker side of the moon, and that part of the moon becomes brighter. This is known as the earth light. Now here is a funny activity. Students, you have to carry out this activity on a playground. Select 3 students. Give them the role of the sun, the moon and the earth. Make the sun stand in the middle. Can you see in the picture? Draw an elliptical orbit around the sun. That means you have to draw a circle. The student who has been given the role of the earth should rotate around himself from west to east. Simultaneously, he should revolve around the student who is the sun along the drawn orbit in the anti-clockwise direction. Can you see in the picture, students? Make sure that the student who is performing the role of the moon is also revolving around the one who is acting as the earth. So here we can see that the student in the role of the moon is revolving around the earth. Graphical explanation. The moon's orbit, that means the path of the revolution, is also elliptical as that of the earth. That means the moon revolves around the earth in an oval shape. So, the distance of the moon from the earth is not the same. There are variations in its distance. Now, observe this diagram, students. Here we'll understand the perigee and apogee position. Perigee position. When the moon is close to the earth, it is known as the perigee position. Here the distance between the moon and the earth is about 356,000 km. Apogee. When the moon is far away from the earth, it is known as apogee position. And here the distance between the moon and the earth is 407,000 kilometers. Now we shall end here, and in our next lecture we'll study about the different phases of the moon as well as the solar and the lunar eclipse. For homework, read the lesson.